Hey everyone, Eran Stern here, and in this quick tutorial I'll show you how to match a curvature surface distortion using the camera tracker and few other effects. So this is the clip that we are going to use. This is courtesy of Pexels, and I'll put a link to it if you want to follow along. You can download the clip as well. Anyhow, I'm just going to escape out of full screen. I'll go to the beginning, I'll select this shot, and first I'll go to the animation menu and select track camera and let After Effects analyze the shot. Once completed, I'm going to look for a nice surface over here. I'll click and then I'll right click on the target and create text and camera. I'll double click on the text and I'll type down the word the curve. I'll click to accept and then I'll return to the selection tool and use the 3D gizmo to just place this in the desired location. By the way, I'm using the URW Dean Condensed font and the weight is black. I'm also going to press S and scale it just a touch, something like this. Maybe also lower it down. And also let's change the blending mode from normal to overlay so it will merge nicely with the ground. Now, if I'm going to play the result, you will see that it tracks beautifully to the shot. However, it doesn't really register the curvature of this slope. So let's see if we can make it better. I'll pause the preview, I'll select the text, and if you want to distort it so it will be more in line with what we have over here, one way to work is to add the Bezier warp effect. I'll double click on it, just to show you that for text and shape layers, which are always continuously rasterized, all the effects that we are going to apply are going to be calculated using the comp dimensions. So it is really difficult to control the distortion. And also, if I'm going to move my playhead, you can see that it's actually going to move the layer. So it doesn't register correctly. Instead, I'll delete this effect from this layer, and I'll duplicate another version just so we'll have something to compare with what we are getting over here. So I'll press Command or Control D, and for this layer, I'm going to take away the 3D option. I'm also going to open it up and reset the transformation. So basically it is now back to normal. Let's also change the blending mode to normal as well. And then I'll go to the layer menu and choose Pre-compose. I'll name this composition text, making sure to open it. Now over here, what I would like to do is crop this composition to the dimensions of the text. So to do it, I can click on the region of interest and then marquee around the edges of the text. Something like this will work, and then go to the composition menu and choose crop comp to region of interest. Now I can close this layer and I need to make sure that this layer has the same position coordinates in 3D space as the original text. So I'll reconvert it to a 3D layer, and let's also change the blending mode to overlay. And to help me match the transformation, I'll right click over here and make sure that for the columns, I can see the parent and link column. Next, I'll hold down Shift and use the parent and link pick whip and point it to the text layer. And because Shift is held down, it is going to inherit the same position in 3D space. Now, because we cropped and moved this layer, we need to reposition it. So I'll change the 3D gizmo to show me just the position properties. And then I'll wait for the X and start to drag it. And then lower it using the Y axis. And I can return back to the universal gizmo. So now we basically created the same thing. However, if I'll switch off the visibility for the original one and double click on the Bezier warp to apply it to this layer, now I have the controls in the correct position. So I can use the image below as a reference and create or try to match the same distortion, the same warping to what I'm seeing. Something along those lines. Let's press Command Shift H to hide the layer bounds and see where we are. And if I move the timeline, you can see that this distortion now stick with the text. And just to compare it to the original version, I'm going to take a snapshot, switch off the visibility, turn on the visibility of the original text, and then click on the show snapshot to show you the difference. This is a minor thing, but it looks much more believable. All right, let's make it even better by creating a less sharpened version of this text. And we can do it using the roughen edges effect. Double click to apply it to the same layer. Let's change the border to 5 and the complexity maybe to 5 as well. Zoom in so we can see the effect. This is the before and this is after, maybe a little bit more. So I'll raise this to 8 and you can see that this is basically creating a fractal noise effect only on the edges, on the alpha channel of the text, making it look a bit more grungy and appropriate. We can always return to the Bezier warp effect and continue to work with it now that we are seeing it so close and personal. Another thing that we may want to do is texturize it a bit more, so make it a little less clean, and we can do it using a texture, and I already have this texture over here. There is a link in the description below. This is a free image from Adobe Stock. And what I would like to do before dragging it to the composition, let's select the comp, zoom out, is duplicate the text layer, so Command or Control D, and then hold down Option here on the Mac, Alt on the Windows side, and drag and drop this, and this is going to use the same dimensions, so another way to basically inherit the same transformation properties, as well as all the other effects that we've applied. So we don't need the roughened edges in this case, I'll delete it. And I also don't think that the texture should be in an overlay blending mode, so I'll change it to normal. What we want to do is just use the pixels over here as a luma mat to the text itself. So I'll use the track mat pick whip this time and point it to the texture. Click once over here to change it from alpha mat to luma mat. And let's zoom in again so we can see how this works. And because both of those layers are in the same 3D space, the texture is going to move with the image. Now, in this case, I think the texture is a bit too strong, so I'll add a fast box blur effect. And let's just change the blur radius to 2, maybe even 1. And I think it will help to sell it even better. All right, let's zoom out, go to the beginning, and I'll click on the shy icon here to show you that I have a few more layers here. I'm going to drag them and place them above all the other layers. This is another text that I've created over here, as well as a rotobrushed version of this guy, just to hide the other title that I've created. And I'm using the same techniques that I showed you. This time, the title doesn't need to be curved, but it will help to tell the story. All right, let's go to the beginning, maximize the composition panel, and preview the result. So this is it for this tutorial. I hope these techniques are going to help you with your work. And remember, unlike this guy, always wear a helmet when you are riding your skateboard.